When it comes to planets, there's a lot more than meets the eye. Thankfully, false color images show us what our eyes are missing. Hey guys, Amy with you on DNews, talking pretty things in space. Thanks to decades of science missions, we've learned a lot about what the planets are made of, and that has let us figure out what their true colors are. Mars is red because the rocks are rusty. Venus's surface is actually gray, but we can only see the thick sulfuric acid atmosphere that envelops the whole planet. Uranus and Neptune are both primarily made of methane, a gas that absorbs red light and bounces back blue-green light. That's why both planets have a rich blue tone to them. So if these are the planets' true colors, why do we sometimes see them looking like a psychedelic vision? Because false color is a thing that scientists love. Across the whole electromagnetic spectrum, the human eye can only see a small section, the so-called visible light spectrum from violet to red that corresponds to a wavelength range of 400 to 700 nanometers. The human eye can't see longer or shorter wavelengths outside that visible range, infrared and radio on the longer end of the spectrum and ultraviolet on the shorter end. So scientists use tools to see in these wavelengths. In some cases, imaging a body in a different wavelength reveals things that we can't see. This composite image of Saturn's moon Titan was taken in infrared light by the Cassini spacecraft's visual and infrared mapping spectrometer. In visible light, Titan only shows its hazy atmosphere, but in the near-infrared, we can see through the clouds to the surface. Radar is another way to look through what we can't in visible light. This image of Venus was made using radar data from the Magellan spacecraft. The radar penetrated through the dense atmosphere to reveal Venus's surface topography, and this color-coded map makes the information easy to read. Sometimes looking in a different wavelength is a way to see more detail. On the left is Jupiter in true color. On the right is a false color image made from three separate pictures taken through filters focusing on specific spectral regions. Two were taken through filters looking for the absorption of the gas methane, and one was taken in a red continuum that wouldn't show any absorption. The result shows details in Jupiter's atmosphere that are invisible to the naked eye. Some false color images are designed to highlight differences in surface material, like this one of Mercury. Gray in visible light owing to the iron rocks that litter its surface, Mercury looks vibrant when color is used to enhance the separation between chemical, mineralogical, and physical variation within the surface material. Another striking image is this one of the dwarf planet Pluto. Red in visible light because of tholins, this false color image was made using a technique called principal component analysis that highlights the subtle color differences between regions on the planet's surface. There's a lot to learn about the planets from all kinds of stunning images, but it's not the case that whoever sees something first can claim it as their own. There is such a thing as space law, and Test Tube News talks about it in this video right here.
About 2 years before the US successfully put a man on the moon, a treaty was drawn up between the US, the UK, and the Soviet Union, which created the foundation of international space law. The Outer Space Treaty, as it's known today, bans things like nuclear weapons testing in space.
And there's a lot more to space than just planets. If you want to come and explore other facets of space with me, come check out my own channel, Vintage Space. Gemini had a lot more orbital capabilities. It was also conceived of as a system that would land on a runway using a paraglider. We'll have a link to both of those in the description if you're on mobile. So do you guys like false color images, or do you prefer your planet's own natural? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.